Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the Infowars Nightly News. I'm your host, Aaron Dykes, on this Tuesday, September 25th, 2012.
Tonight, shocking images of a state-sponsored execution in China as a villager is brutally crushed to death after refusing a forced government relocation. Then, Monsanto launches damage control over GMO cancer study. Plus, Harvard researchers now ridiculously insist that fluoride only lowers IQ levels outside the United States. Yeah, right. And Alex Jones talks with Amy Larson, who was recently arrested for writing 9/11 was an inside job on the sidewalk. That's coming up next on the InfoWars Nightly News.
Tonight in news, a shocking and graphic story as a man was trampled underneath a street paving car on orders of a Chinese Communist Party official in China. A villager in northern China was resisting a forced government relocation and tried to remain on his land and was instead brutally crushed to death by a road flattening truck on orders of a Chinese government official. The victim was He Zihua, and he refused to accept the paltry money they gave him under the pretense of eminent domain, telling him to move away from his land, and instead laid down in the path of the construction workers, refusing to leave his property. And his reward for standing up to that was death in this world, but he's surely made a mark for land rights and for individual rights across the world. This is just another horrific example of the face of tyranny, not just in China, but around the world. This is New World Order behavior, ready to relocate anyone in their path and ready to kill anyone who stands up to that. It's extremely reminiscent of the Tiananmen Square massacres that happened in 1989. Hundreds and hundreds, actually I read the number was 1,400 protesters killed by tanks and otherwise killed by government soldiers. Of course, there was that one iconic tank man who stood up to the tanks, blocked their path, and at least one of the tank drivers showed his humanity and was not able to just brutally run someone over. But this is just one more protest in the ongoing current occupation of China, of villagers saying no to attempts to steal their crops, to take over the land and turn it over to commercial development. In most cases, they weren't even told that their land was being sold off by the Chinese party officials. And so they are rightfully outraged. There's been riots in all kinds of Chinese villages. We've covered some of those stories over the years. There's so many of them, though, but it's good to see someone standing up. Of course, they have tried to suppress this story, keeping it out of the state-controlled media, trying to keep it off of the web, but news is spreading here at Infowars.com. It was posted on DrudgeReport.com, and it's otherwise going across the alternate, so something to keep in mind there in China. This story also brings to mind the horrific example that happened with Rachel Corrie in Gaza. She was a protester trying to block literal bulldozers about to steam over Palestinian homes and what have you, and she was, well, it's debated, but she was run over by the bulldozer. Her parents sued the government, raised a lawsuit, and ultimately they didn't win that lawsuit, but they did point out the fact that she was basically murdered, as this Chinese villager clearly was as well. And it's really the kind of eminent domain disregard for human life we're going to see under Agenda 21. We turn now to for rent, your very own Agenda 21 shoebox apartment, how they're springing up in New York, in Boston, and now in San Francisco, little micro apartments being sold on the trendiness and cuteness aimed at single individuals living in very tiny homes. In the case of San Francisco, they actually had to drop the minimum requirements for housing spaces. They're trying to re-regulate that, so even smaller apartments are allowed. The minimum size just for a living room is larger than the type of apartment they're trying to construct in San Francisco for $1,400 to $1,900 a month, a little tiny micro 225 square foot apartment. Once you take out the space for closets and bathrooms, that's 150 square feet, 10 by 15. That's the compacting. That is Agenda 21 trying to eliminate the family, create living spaces that aren't big enough to have children in or spouses or pets. pets. They want to compact everyone into tightly regulated zones where no one could be sustainable. All in the name of sustainable development, of course. This is taking people out of rural areas, driving them into the integrated, compacted cities that they plan under all this smart growth and other related plans. And it's just to make people dependent on government, unable to take care of themselves, and of course to make some rent money and destroy other living options. And this all ties into an update I filed. It's a follow-up to our more thorough investigation on Agenda 21 and the way they're taking over at the local level by pushing smart growth, by pushing sustainable communities, and trying to talk even rural towns into building these concentrated development zones, places where, in particular, they want people to live in the same buildings they work. They call them shop houses. They already have that in China, too, by the way. The dormitories where they pack five people into a room and you live in slave conditions and then you work all day in the factories and the workers want to kill themselves. Well, that's the kind of thing they're bringing home to America. It's that planned society that is such a bad idea. Unless you're a control freak, New World Order system, then it's exactly what you want. Here's that report now. Aaron Dykes here with a quick update from Infowars.com investigating the stealth implementation of the United Nations Agenda 21 right here in the United States under the name of sustainable communities. So why is this important? To oppose Agenda 21 is to oppose the planned society, as the cartoon Plannedopolis tried to convince us.
I'm looking forward to showing you around Plannedopolis today.
Where we were told how great life would be under a centralized system.
No, not meat. It's not your birthday. The Global Food Council are doing a really good job of keeping food production going.
Directed by technology.
Switch off brain and go to work. With this many people around, I'm glad there's a mega computer in charge.
Despite the fact that our lives would be tightly controlled, including calorie restrictions.
Have you got your calorie card open on your smartphone?
Transportation restrictions.
I registered your visit with Slick Travel Corp the other day, so they've allotted you a journey time.
People have asked, what's so bad about Agenda 21? The founders believed in a separation of powers, but the modern-day framers worked through the United Nations, through bankers working with communist and collectivist systems, and through environmental groups who want to seize land and redirect it for the vision of a few who wish to rule from the top. It's taking away our free will. You know, the American way. To fight against Agenda 21 is to oppose the straitjacket being imposed upon us under global and environmental pretexts. I want you to think for a minute about the existing neighborhood and housing regulations people voluntarily sign up for when they move into different neighborhoods, how tall your grass can be, whether or not you can have a basketball court or a fishing boat or an RV in your front yard, or in many cases even in your backyard. You've seen the news articles where people aren't allowed to grow gardens in many areas. That is nothing compared to what's coming. If you followed the cap and trade laws that they tried to pass through Congress that were narrowly defeated only because there was a huge outcry, those thousands of pages were going to implement all kinds of new regulations on people's homes, on the kind of cars they can drive, on top of the already existing burdensome regulations. They were going to have housing inspectors, new rules on what kind of light bulbs you can have, and on. It was this endless laundry list. That's the kind of thing we're seeing happening under sustainable development. It's not sustainable at all. I can give you dozens and dozens, if not hundreds, of quotes from leading globalists who say they want to destroy society.
Mari Strong, one of the leading advocates for Agenda 21 and a speaker at the United Nations Rio Summit in 1992, said, "Isn't the only hope for the planet that the industrialized civilizations collapse? Isn't it our responsibility to bring that about?"
A number of these environmental groups have said things to the same effect. They want to stop growth. That's what smart growth, so-called, is all about. It's not about new developments. It's about controlling and steering where humanity is allowed to go. They say they don't want there to be another United States in the developing world. They don't want other countries to be brought up to our living standards. They want to lower the United States living standards to a third world area, greatly reduce the population across the globe and here at home, and have more and more say in your life, what you're allowed to do on your own land, because it's now going to be rezoned under these sustainable development plans. And it's just like the things we've already seen in China. In fact, the workshop I was at in Elgin for these sustainable communities specifically talked about shop houses where they would have workers live in the same buildings they were working at. That's already going on in China, and it's nightmarish. You've heard about the Foxconn
factory workers who commit suicide to such an extent that they have to put up suicide nets so that their own workers can't escape their own lives. They're basically slaves. You can call it what you want. We spoke to a number of people throughout the community as well as these local bureaucrats, and some of them recognize that these kind of plans to contain humanity and tell you how big or what kind of house you can live in is a Chinese-style tyranny. Come home to America.
Agenda 21 is a plan we've been signed on to with the United Nations where we'd give up our property rights and freedom and be forced to live in apartments no bigger than this square. What do you think about that?
I think that's terrible. It sounds kind of like Chinese foreign policy or interior policy regarding their house and how they're controlling all aspects of your life.
And furthermore, communist China really is the ultimate class system. We're trained to think of communism as a leveling, as an equalizing of everyone, but it's actually not. It's the ultimate insider scheme. Party bureaucrats who control that communist model, they regulate all land. They have the final say in who's allowed to buy, sell, and use that land, and they take it from ordinary people and redistribute it in a nepotism to their friends, their family, other top regulators. That's the true class system. I just wanted to throw that in there.
Agenda 21 is a wide-spanning plan to contain humanity in the 21st century. Be aware of this international scheme. Be informed and help stop this plan in your local area before it's too late.
And so you can find that on Infowars.com under the headline, Globalists Want Chinese-Style Control for Americans Under Agenda 21. I wrote a brief article linking to our updated video with that update you just saw, as well as the longer report exposing the Agenda 21 implementation, how it ties into the national agenda, as well as more of our detailed background information that we couldn't give you in that compact and produced presentation that's up on Infowars tonight on YouTube. And it'll be up shortly on the Alex Jones channel. So check that out. There's also prisonplanet.tv. We go now to another incident where our reporters were confronted by police just for trying to exercise their First Amendment. Film footage, in this case, by the Alamo, where they were told the media is not welcome unless they have prior clearance. What do they have to hide at the Alamo? I don't.
State Department. You have a permit.
You're welcome to come in with that.
But it's funded by tax
state.
It's funded by state taxpayers.
No, it's not.
It's not taxed by state taxpayers?
Who's this is funded by the gift shop donations. No, it belongs to the state, but the state doesn't fund it.
Yeah, but it's a state problem. You have right to film. If you're saying I'm violating the rules
okay,
right now,
this is
right?
State property.
Hold on. If I'm violating the rules right now, like those people taking video right there, that gentleman with the camera, it's public.
If I can have you off state property, you're fine.
This is private property.
What did I just say? I'm not talking to you.
Well, I'm with the news media also. I'm with him.
Okay. Like I said, if you have a permit.
You can roll this.
No. Off there or you go to jail. Pick one.
Ask a question as a public servant?
Nope.
Well, you're a public servant.
So what about the other people filming and taking video?
If it's state property, it's paid for by the taxpayers. A ranger stated that we cannot step on the property because it was state owned. And he refused to speak on camera.
You need a permit to exercise your First Amendment. You hear everybody? They want us to get a permit to exercise our First Amendment on this property here. Sir, why are we not allowed on this property here?
These are the rules.
The rules of what?
Those are the rules.
Now, is this or is this not state property?
These are the rules, sir.
Is this state property?
These are the rules.
Are these rules or are you just making this stuff up?
Those are rules.
So we're not allowed on this property because we belong to the media. Hey, everybody, you're not allowed to take video or pictures of this property because it's state property. The Constitution is the law of the land. You people need to realize that and understand that. Sir, we were told that we could not step on this property here because we're filming. Is that true?
Correct.
Now, is this or is this not state property?
Would you like to go inside and talk about it?
The officer said if we stepped on this state property here, we'd be arrested.
No. You're not going to be arrested, but if you want to go inside, we can talk about it in my office, and we can figure out what you want and what you need. And
all I'm trying to do is do a little film here. I want to ask people questions. That's all. You know, First Amendment.
Film out here, you can film off the curb line. On here, there's no filming allowed. No interviews allowed.
No filming allowed.
State property.
What's that?
Why is that? Why can't we step?
You have to take that up with the state.
Oh, no, sir. If you take a look, there's people with video cameras right there, a woman with a video camera, there's a guy with a camera.
I understand.
What's the difference?
you're conducting an interview and you want to interrupt these people's vacations.
We're not interrupting nobody.
You want to interrupt these people's vacations and do your business. Those are the rules that were established, and that's the rules that we stand by. It's not going to help anything. It's not going to help your cause. It's not going to allow you to get up here.
I'm not here for any cause. All I'm here is to exercise my First Amendment. The state property falls under the First Amendment of the Constitution. Is that or is that not correct?
I'm not going to get into debate with you.
Sir, you're the PIO. You have to answer that question.
Let me answer you this way. I'm not going to get into a debate with you on that right now.
I'm not debating. I'm just stating the law. This is the law of the land.
Here's the thing. The law is you cannot film on this.
And what's the law? What's the code, sir?
If you want to take that up with the General Land Office on Monday.
Yeah, but what's the law? What is the law? Could you recite the law, please?
Do you have any other questions?
Could you recite the law?
Do you have any other questions?
Sir, and to you recite the law, we're allowed to step on this. You understand that?
You're not.
What's the law? Could you please get somebody to recite the law for us right now?
The rules and regulations.
Where's the rules and regulations? Where's the law? No, this is state property.
I will show you where they're at. I'm not going to sit here and get in a debate with you over something.
If we follow you, I'm keeping the camera rolling. That's how it goes.
The camera has to stay here.
No, it's how it goes for our protection. So
these guys are not going to allow you on this property. That's the way that it is.
On whose property is that again?
Whose property?
On this property, right?
Whose property? Is this the people's property or your property?
Okay, do you have any other questions?
Yeah, but you're not answering my questions.
Do you have any?
Yes, I do.
That's relevant.
Yes, I do, sir. Could you recite the law, please, that says we can't go on state property?
Gentlemen, you know the rules?
Yes, sir.
And
whose rules are they?
If you have anything else, come and see me.
Sir, you're not answering our question. You're walking away. Sir, you're not answering our questions.
You don't know the answer. You know
something. There's no law saying we can't be on this property.
This is state property. This is our property. This is taxpayer property.
This is the people's property, not the New World Order's. Because you don't know the law. Because you're making it up.
No, they said it's rules. It's not even laws.
You're making the rules up. There is no law. And this is a prime example of federal takeover, folks. It's disgusting. We need a permit to step on this piece of property right here. When he clarified that it was state property, therefore, it falls under the First Amendment of the Constitution. And these officers right here are going to dishonor their oaths if I stepped off on this property and arrest me for exercising my First Amendment. And, sir, you guys took an oath to be in office. Is that correct?
Have a nice day, sir.
Have a nice day. You know, you should read the Constitution, you guys. That's the law of the land. Problem. That's why our country's falling apart, because of people like you guys. You don't know the Constitution. You let these global scum step all over us. It's disgusting.
Turning to health news, there's a new ridiculous claim that the Harvard study showing that fluoride is dangerous, it causes brain damage, is somehow not affecting people inside the United States, only in China where the test subjects came from. It's at Natural News by Ethan Huff. Harvard now ridiculously insists that fluoride only lowers IQ levels outside of the United States. This ties into a push in Wichita, Kansas, one of the few remaining large metropolitan areas not yet fluoridating their water, where they're trying to push for that fluoridation, and they're writing articles in those local controlled media papers trying to convince people that, well, this only applies to the water levels in China, trying to imply without evidence that they don't fluoridate water to the same levels here in the U.S., which isn't true, specifically relating to the 2.4 milligrams per liters level used in the Harvard study, saying that, well, in Wichita, it would only be 0.7 milligrams per liter. Well, the problem is it's accumulative. If you keep drinking the water, that's going to affect you over time. If you drink it over the course of your life, it's going to affect your thyroid, it's going to affect your glands, your tissues, your brain. This stuff is dangerous. We don't need it in our water. And even as these Harvard studies come out, other scientific peer-reviewed studies point to the dangers of fluoride. You still see the controlled media trying to push for it, always trying to tell you, well, it's good for teeth. Drink the poison down. That entire article is up at Natural News and Infowars.com. Then we have an economic news. Just as QE3 is launched and we're told Ben Bernanke is going to unlimitedly pump tens of billions of dollars per month into the economy, that, well, that won't be enough. We're going to need QE4. Yes, there's already financial figures calling for it. Folks have barely even started QE3, and yet on Wall Street, they're clamoring for QE4. That's a Michael Snyder article. In fact, as you will read below, one equity strategist at Morgan Stanley says he wouldn't be surprised if the Federal Reserve announced another round of money printing by the end of the year. And that's only a few months away. Obviously, we're here in September. This is such a crazy strategy, just QE3 alone, that even former Federal Reserve Chairman Paul Volcker, very much part of the New World Order operation system, has decried it, said it makes no sense, and that this form of quantitative easing is only adding to the problem. And again, this is just part of that drug addiction phenomenon where Wall Street bankers are addicted to this easy money. They just want another hit, because they know how to use it to gain assets. It helps the big boys take control of real assets. It never helps the little people. It's not stimulating the middle class. It's not stimulating the economy. It's just this Ponzi scheme game that's going to go until it accelerates the collapse to a point of no return. Now, you've heard about the new GMO studies where they found that Monsanto's genetically engineered corn was causing tumors in rats in the first ever scientifically peer-reviewed long-term study that is longer than 90 days. All of the studies favoring Monsanto or the other genetically engineered companies, supposedly showing that GMOs are safe to eat, have all been short-term studies, very tightly controlled with blinders on, to say, yes, it was safe this time, let's launch it, let's fast-track approve it, let's go. Now, you've got this French scientist coming out with the first long-term study showing these rats over the course of their lives, over many more months than the studies previously held, and it shows that this stuff is dangerous. We know that from other studies that were not done by the genetically engineered companies, but those were all tossed aside, smeared in the media, and now they're predictably smearing this study. Once again, you've got Monsanto launching a campaign to do damage control over this GMO study, linking it to cancer, organ failure, and what have you. Paul Joseph Watson has the detailed report, but you've got to look at the fact that Monsanto, Coca-Cola, Pepsi, and the other GMO firms pushing this stuff on the general public are spending $19 million. I read in one article it was $25 million just in California to keep labeling away, to not label the fact that ingredients contain genetically modified organisms. I thought it was safe. What's the big deal? Well, they know the public is aware. They've heard about GMO being dangerous, and they know if it's on the labels, that's going to hurt their sales. So make food available that doesn't have GMOs. People would readily buy it. But they're afraid of it being on the label and cutting into their monopolistic game to put everyone in the population on that kind of food supply. And so if it's safe, why are they trying to keep this stuff hidden? That's all in the article. And again, going into the details of the French study, they found that 50% of males, 70% of females fed this diet developed tumors within I think it was 19 months in most cases, and some of the other rats also developed tumors and cancers, but not nearly as quickly as the rats fed this GMO corn. And with this kind of damning evidence, they're just trying to attack the messenger. Well, you've got the article in Reuters where the scientist Gilles Eric Serenellini of the University of Caen is defending his study and saying he's waiting for criticism from real scientists, other scientists who've actually published materials in journals on the effects of GMOs and pesticides in order to debate this issue fairly. And he says if there's real criticism, bring it. But what he's been brought, the criticism you've seen in the media and the past week trying to spin the study comes from lobbyists. And you look at Bill Gates Foundation, you look at Monsanto, they're funding in many cases the actual scientific journals, giving them mega grants that completely is a conflict of interest, does not lend itself to peer-reviewed real science, and really aims to do a disservice against the public and keep them in the dark by design, of course. It's a case-by-case deal, but Jeffrey M. Smith has been on the show many times. He's just put out this new video, Genetic Roulette. It's an accompaniment to his detailed book, Genetic Roulette. There's also Scientists Under Attack, GMO Trilogy, The point I'm trying to make here is the dangers of GMO are well known. The dangers of GMO are well known. They know it causes organ failure. They know it causes sterility, infertility. They know it's causing these long-term problems. There's been other studies, but the media has spun them, hid them, keeping them in the dark. In some cases, going back decades, they physically destroyed, flooded, damaged computers, laboratories where they were conducting research that didn't lend itself to the official story promoted by the big agriculture giants. And it's just disgusting. One example of that showed up yesterday on the Alex Jones Show when Mike Adams was hosting. He had on Anthony Giucciardi of Natural Society. And let's just take a look at that clip, some of the stuff said in that letter.
But here's this email, and I've taken out the expletive words, the curse words that's littered, all caps, a lot of these words. You might see it on the screen. Here it is. I am no traitor against humanity. If this expletive causes infertility, awesome, with three exclamation points. Awesome. It's awesome it causes infertility. The world is overpopulated and people need to stop having children. This is one of the Earth's largest problems. If the Earth wasn't overpopulated, things like growth hormones wouldn't exist. The reason they do is that the Earth cannot produce enough food on its own to feed us all. This is why GMO is actually saving the planet. And then you can see how angry he is when he says, so expletive you and you're expletive. You can imagine what that means. I am doing humanity, this is all caps, a expletive favor.
We're showing the email on screen for those of you watching on prisonplan.tv. I am doing humanity a blank favor. That
blanking
is
favor. Yes, all caps as well.
And you have confirmed that this is from the scientific, let's just say, I'm not going to give the name, but an entity very well known in the scientific community. And I've independently confirmed that as well.
It's one of the top three. We'll just say that. It's someone that was so upset that they didn't take the necessary steps to protect themselves that they may have known about. They were just so enraged. You can tell from this email, this guy's talking from pure hatred. And he says things like, if the world wasn't so overpopulated, things like growth hormones wouldn't exist.
And again, that is shocking stuff that just gives away the true attitude of the elite towards the population they're supposedly doing the best they can for. And it's just more evidence. We've got to stop this GMO. This has got to be a huge issue. People need to spread news about this study everywhere. We cannot let the media spin this issue. We know the truth. It's in these other studies. We've just got to compile it and get it out to the public before it's too late. So we turn now to the Daily Quote, which is related. It comes out of a university professor under genetics. In an ecosystem, you can always intervene and change something in it. But there's no way of knowing what all the downstream effects will be or how it might affect the environment. We have such a miserably poor understanding of how the organism develops from its DNA that I would be surprised if we don't get one rude shock after another. That's Professor Richard Lewontin, professor of genetics at Harvard. And that says it all right there. They thought 96% of our DNA was junk. They've told us they can just manipulate GMO organisms and feed them to animals, and it doesn't matter what the consequences are. Doesn't matter if it's causing new foodborne allergies. Doesn't matter if it's a total genocidal epidemic. Just we know best. We're the scientists. We're the elite. I'm furious about this, but I'm going to go now to Alex's extended update. He's got all kinds of news coverage, and then after that, a powerful interview. Stay tuned. This is the Infowars Nightly News. You can support us, of course, at prisonplanet.tv, and you can create your own channel of information and help get the word out at planetinfowars.com. Thanks for watching.
I don't know about you, but I am sick and tired of people, especially media whores and mainstream media, telling us all day that we live in the freest, greatest country in the world. I love America. I care about our republic, and our nation certainly in the past was one of the models for freedom. I'm proud of America, and that's why I'm tired of globalists that have hijacked this country lecturing me all day that I should be happy about our loss of liberties because, after all, we're free. They have different university gauges and breakdowns around the world that show on the index of economic freedom, the United States is now 18th. And when it comes to civil liberties, we're even worse. This country is losing its basic freedoms. In fact, in some of the statistics I've seen, we're rated number 6 in the world as the worst police state out there. But those are just statistics. Look at the evidence. We have one of the lowest life expectancies in the industrialized world. We have the lowest test scores in the industrialized world. We're now behind a bunch of third world nations. We have the worst obesity, the highest cancer rates, the highest autism rates. Across the board, America is falling apart by design. And now the globalists are saying they want to censor the internet, and they want to arrest peaceful protesters and have the Department of Defense ask the court to keep them in jail because terrorism is being committed by their protest. We see the new terrorism manual saying that gun owners, conservatives, libertarians, returning veterans are the number one terror threat, not Al-Qaeda, that our government publicly runs and is turning loose in the Middle East. Paul Watson wrote a big story today titled 30 Examples of Why America is No Longer a Free Country. And I want to look at just a few of the examples here. I mean, look at these. All over the nation, mothers and fathers are being arrested for their children playing in the front yard or in the cul-de-sac or in the backyard. People are being arrested for lemonade stands. The Amish are being SWAT teamed for selling milk to their neighbors. The system has gone wild, and this has happened many times before in history. Here are just a few of these examples. In fact, the first one, we're going to be interviewing this woman coming up in studio in the next segment. Sidewalk chalk provokes police. The woman wrote YouTube Building 7, the 47-story building that wasn't hit by a plane that fell on 9/11, and so they arrested her and are charging her with felony vandalism. Here's another example out of the New York Post. New York City schools give out morning after pills to students without telling the parents of 10, 11, and 12-year-olds. All over the United States, public schools are taking 11, 12, 13-year-olds to have abortions without getting parental consent. In California and New Jersey, they're giving children inoculations without parental consent and saying it's okay, the child gave consent. So what happens when a pedophile tries to pick up your 10-year-old? Will it be okay because the child gave consent? Children can't give consent until 18 years of age. That's why the 10-year-old bought the heroin from me. They gave consent. They cannot give consent. Government is acting like drug dealers and perverts, pedophiles. Quite frankly, they're made up of a bunch of those people, so what do you expect? The worst elements are getting into government. Criminals are getting into government, so they have a badge to protect themselves. Here's another one. New Jersey attempts to strip parental rights with vaccine anti-exemption bill. They're saying, we don't care if you don't want to give your kids shots. We're going to force them to take them. See, in the past, they've lied and said, it's the law to take vaccines. Now that people are finding out that's a lie, another hoax, they're saying, okay, we'll pass a law. Just like they've passed laws in multiple states to say, hey, no more sodium fluoride in our water that brain damages and gives us cancer. And so now the feds are coming in and getting the states to pass laws blocking cities and counties from not having fluoride in their water. Even when the Harvard study came out 2 months ago admitting 20-point IQ reductions and massive cancer increases. Here's another one. Remember this one? Woman faces jail time for growing vegetable garden in her own lawn. ABC News. Boom. And there wasn't even a law up in Michigan that she couldn't have a garden. They just said, we find it objectionable, we and the zoning board. Tennessee man arrested and imprisoned for using cash. This came out of the Shelbyville Gazette. And in this report, he paid for something with a 50 that was a real 50, but was the 50s before 5 years ago that didn't have the color on them. And so they arrested him, and the cops said, we don't care if it was real money. So-called real money, Federal Reserve money. You should have new money. You should have new money, you American scum. So there's that report. Here's another one. Texas woman sues Walmart for ripping up her $100 bills. She's trying to pay for 50-something dollars with 100. They say, this isn't real, and rip it up. The manager comes. She says, look, I got another one. I just sold my car. It's real. He rips it up again. The police come and go, no, it's a real $100 bill. Folks, this is the demonization of cash. I went to a Starbucks where I rarely go a few weeks ago and bought $20+ worth of stuff. Croissants for my kids, milks for them, coffees for my wife and I, a bottle of water. 20-something bucks. I give the woman a 50. It's all I had. She goes, I can't do this. I said, well, see if it's real. She puts the mark. Doesn't matter. I can't. I said, you get your manager. Oh, Alex, what are you doing? Causing problems. Knew who I was. I said, causing problems? You want everything tracked. Well, it gets worse. It just came out earlier this week that in Florida, and the court ruled it's okay, paying with a $5 bill, 50s down to fives, they call the police on you and put you in a database. It is absolutely amazing that they put you in a database for using cash. The toll roads are already tracking where you go. The transponders you use, they've caught them tracking you outside of the toll road areas. The toll roads are buying up newspapers, buying up mayors where I live, so no one can oppose. This is how you control societies. The Romans said all roads lead to Rome. That's how they control commerce. So there's that report. Total demonization of cash across the board. Continuing, society now criminalizing parents that allow children to play in the yard. I got this lady coming on later in the week. A woman outside Houston, a rural area, had her children playing on bicycles and scooters in a cul-de-sac area. My kids did that when we lived in the city. And they came and arrested her, even though she was in the front yard watching them. And we've got other reports of where this is happening with mothers with their kids in the backyard. Ladies and gentlemen, if you want to know where the world's going, it's going to this article today by Paul Joseph Watson at Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. It's also on the left-hand side of DrudgeReport.com if you can't find it on Infowars.com. And the Communist Party officials in front of everyone where they were kicking these farmers off their land said, drive the steamroller over the person. Shades of Tiananmen Square when one person didn't just stop one tank, but more than 20 tanks backed out behind them when you see the full uncropped photo. And whereas 20-something years ago, we all felt empathy for a lone human standing up against tyranny. Now today, it's not even in our news when China engages in these incredible types of tyranny. So if you want to know where the world's going, the globalists have signed on to ship all our jobs to China, not to help the Chinese people, who are hard-working, smart folks, but to deindustrialize us and lower the global standard of living, to create poverty so we're more manageable and controllable. As Aaron Dykes' piece last night broke down eloquently, Agenda 21 is the communist Chinese model. In fact, Maury Strong and others have admitted that. That's their model. So this is the incredible dehumanization. Look at this report out of the Wall Street Journal. Apple supplier Foxconn says fight at plant spread into larger unrest. This is where they have suicide nets around the factories. They have pregnancy tests, and if you're pregnant, they abort your baby at abortuaries on the spot. And again, the worst offenders in this entire situation is the factories that are being funded and run by Apple and Al Gore on its board while he lectures us about human rights all day and how great NAFTA and GATT would be and how paying him and the Rothschild Exchange trillions of dollars a year for carbon dioxide that plants breathe is going to save the earth. These people are a joke. And if you want to know where all this is going, you need to read the article by Melissa Melton for rent, your very own Agenda 21 shoebox apartment, where they charge you more than a 5,000 square foot apartment for 250 to 300 square feet. That's how these scammers operate. And they own all the major parties in almost every country. The few countries they don't control, they're busy trying to overthrow right now. These are scientific tyrants. And I leave you with this in this report by Frank Zappa. Politics is the entertainment division of the military-industrial complex, and he is absolutely right. We're going to go to break and come back here on InfoWars Nightly News with Amy Larson, who was arrested and charged with a felony. She's facing a year in jail, $10,000 fine, her arraignment's tomorrow, for drawing on chalk, with chalk, on the sidewalk, what she paid for, totally protected political speech, that you should YouTube Building 7. Just like they arrested that Marine, Brandon Robb, for writing about Building 7 on his Facebook. They're scared, folks, that when you see the cops saying, get back, they're blowing it up, and they blow up that building, they blew them all up. They know it's over. They know they'll go to prison. They have committed to this eugenics takeover. They are going all the way. They're not going to back off unless we have a mass awakening to these criminals and say no to these people now. Listen, you're not a slave, and it's time to say no to the system. It's time to resist the system. It's time to say, you're out of line. I just had my reporters call me before we shot this, Melissa Melton and Jakari Jackson. I sent them down to film the NSA in San Antonio, which spies on everybody illegally, and I knew they'd send the cops up, tell them they couldn't film, and they handed them the ACLU print-offs and the lawsuits that have been won showing you can film government buildings and you can film the TSA. They erased the San Antonio Express News photos a few years ago, and the other local paper. They didn't do it to our reporters because they knew their rights, and they didn't even have to threaten them with a lawsuit. I'm here to defend this republic. I'm here to keep freedom and basic liberties alive, and if we don't stand up for them, we'll lose them. But they backed off. We're training our servants that they're just that, servants, and that the basic liberties and freedoms we're trying to defend are their rights as well. That's their most prized possession as well. Even if they don't know it's their most important possession, it is. All right, we're going to go to break and come back with a true fighter for liberty, a lady who went to jail. The police made fun of her, said horrible things to her. Wait till you hear this story coming up after the break for daring to ride on the sidewalk that people should look into government murder. Again, we're now, if they didn't like what she did in the sidewalk, well, they better get ready, because it's going to happen everywhere. Every time they attack us, we redouble our efforts. Every time they try to shut us up, we intensify our operations. That's why I did this 5 years ago. I only had 5 or 6 crew members. I wanted to stay small. I wanted to be a boutique information warfare operation to encourage others. But because people tried to shut me down, every time they tried it, I simply redouble. Okay, you got to have that commitment, not to just fight back when they try to tyrannize us, but to surge, to turbo surge against tyranny. Because that spirit of eternal resistance against dehumanization is what will propel us to true liberty and what will propel us to the stars. We're going to break. We'll be right back with a true champion of liberty. Stay with us.
Hello, this is Linda West with a special report for Infowars.com. A new DVD has come out by GMO expert and scholar Jeffrey Smith. It's entitled Genetic Roulette. It exposes the shockingly unbelievable connection between the proliferation of GMOs by huge agri-corporations and the huge increase in disease in America.
Things we're seeing today aren't normal. We didn't see them 30 years ago or 50 years ago.
Illnesses that weren't epidemic before are now epidemic.
With this new comprehensive information, we can finally solve the mystery between the rising disease, cancer, allergies, Alzheimer's, premature aging, and even autism.
I'm concerned about all the health issues that I'm seeing, but the one that I am most alarmed about is autistic spectrum, which is literally skyrocketed.
We can't say for sure that GMOs have anything to do with autism, but we can't say for sure that it doesn't. In fact, there's been an increase in autism since GMOs were introduced, and animals that eat GMOs, both in laboratory and in livestock situations, have shown some telltale signs that some practitioners say are linked with autism.
Jeffrey Smith has done the scientific research that finally reveals the truth about GMOs that big agri-corps and the government has tried so hard to cover up. This food conspiracy is making them billionaires and us sick.
He said he lost about 90% of his miniature steers. What the problem was is, I guess he said that they weren't able to process the food correctly and they would bloat up and die from it.
Now that we have the real information, we can make changes. Now we know exactly why diseases are on the rise, surgeries are on the rise, and so many small minds are being stolen from autism. I know today we all have a lot on our plate, but what's on our plate today is killing us. This is Linda West wishing your family a happy and healthy future.
Alex Jones here with a message that could revolutionize health in this country. Going back about a year and a half ago, I began to learn about the incredible health effects of longevity products. Aaron Dykes lost 92 pounds. We're going to show you some before and afters. Aaron, break down what happened, your story.
I've worked really hard with diet and exercise to try to lose weight, but I just didn't get the results. It just didn't happen. Then I saw what you were doing with InfowarsTeam.com. I wasn't even trying to lose weight, but I got it because I wanted to feel better energy. I wanted that nutrition. Didn't even understand how that could kickstart my own weight loss goals, but the products did that for me. I found myself suddenly losing weight, more energetic, wanting to exercise, wanting to eat the right foods.
And they don't even advertise it as weight loss. I want to challenge our radio listeners to go to InfowarsTeam.com, sign up as a distributor, and get wholesale pricing discounts at InfowarsTeam.com. Welcome back to this Tuesday, the 25th day of September 2012 edition of InfoWars Nightly News. We are now joined by a thought criminal hailing from Napa Valley, California. There is an article in the Local Register, "Sidewalk Chalking Provokes Police. Local woman cites free speech." What do you think this is? America? My children have drawn on the sidewalk inside metropolitan Austin. I guess they need to go to jail. I guess all of us do. I guess Target and Walmart and grocery stores selling it are engaged in this horrible crime. She was arrested for her political speech, and on the booking receipt it says, for felony vandalism, what is it, a year in jail, $10,000 fine. And the police at this time are going ahead with it. Now, of course, if your children are out drawing dandelions and sunflowers and princesses and rainbow ponies, everything's fine. This thought criminal is in trouble the same reason that Marine, Mr. Rob, was in trouble. He was on his Facebook talking about 9/11 being an inside job. Well, Amy Larson, which the paper points out has no criminal record and is a business lady there in the town, she wrote YouTube WTC Building 7, which is the 47-story building that fell on its own footprint on September 11th at 5:30 in the afternoon. BBC World and BBC 24 both reported it had already fallen into its own footprint before it fell. So did CNN. I heard CBS Radio say that they blew it up that day. And since then, we have footage, of course, from the police saying, get back, they're blowing it up. So we know why they don't want you to talk about Building 7, ladies and gentlemen. She became an activist in the spring of 07 after witnessing friends deployed to Iraq, then saw Ron Paul on The Daily Show and became involved in the campaign, was a Minnesota state delegate in 08. She now lives out in California the last 4 years, and she listens to InfoWars and is active in Napa, California meetup groups. So just an all-around horrible person, because Thomas Jefferson would obviously think she was a great woman. And she joins us now facing prison. For drawing on the sidewalk, and thank God, a diligent citizen saw it, called police. When the officers didn't do their job and throw an evil First Amendment person in jail, they called them back, by God. You get her. So the thought criminal joins us now via Skype. Thanks for coming on. Tell us about your incredible crime. What do you think this is, Amy, America? And tell us what happened to you.
Hi, nice to be with you. I just was really surprised and, just shocked that this occurred, and I was held in jail for over 30 hours. I went out chalking in the morning, went to the farmer's market, got some beautiful organic vegetables and fruits, and was chalking. A police lady parked her car on the bridge and came up to me and said, hey, what are you doing? I had a call about some vandalism, and she quickly saw that it was chalk, and so she was like, oh, that's totally fine. It's all good. I left. It was a positive interaction at that point. No problem at all. And I continued on my way. She watched me finish chalking that area. She jaywalked across the street to talk to possibly a graffiti guy that was wearing a vest, and I continued on my way. About 5 to 10 minutes later, and two blocks down, she comes and parks backwards on the road next to me and says, "Hey, let me get your name." So I gave her my name, and she wanted to know where I lived, and I said, "I live here in Napa." And at that point, she wanted my birth date as well, and I asked, "Am I being detained?" And she said no, and so I said, "Well, I'm free to go then. I'm gonna go." So she said, "Then yes, I am being detained." I asked, "What for?" And she said, "You need to show me your, you know, give me your information. You know, we've had." She did say that they've had a lot of chalkings in the city parks, and that apparently they are having to pay someone to clean a lot of it up, as residents are calling in complaints about it.
So basically, it's the residents begging for a North Korean nightmare, begging for the nanny state, demanding, you know, "Hey, get back on her. You know, this is illegal." Well, it's obviously unconstitutional when cities pass things like that, and I hope that you challenge it. But let's get into the actual arrest and the fact that it says you were arrested for felony vandalism, which, for people that don't know, is bashing up people's cars with hammers, spray painting people's property, which obviously nobody should do, but chalking the sidewalks. I mean, there's nothing more Americana than doing that, especially when it's a political message on top of it. That is doubly protected.
Yeah. Yeah. And I, you know, I've done a lot of research since this occurred. There's a great Mother Jones article about chalking arrests. And there's a lawyer that has a little video that says, in California, vandalism is maliciously defacing property. His name is Tom Tosdale. And he said, when you express a political or social idea, it's not malicious. Also, in the state of California, it has to be $400 worth of damage or more to be considered a felony rather than a misdemeanor. So kind of on both counts, it didn't really seem right. And also, there's a lot more reasonable way to go about this. Even if you do have a city ordinance and you want to say chalking is illegal, which I think is ridiculous, you could give people a warning, you know, or ask me to stop, or ask me to clean it up. There was a lot of other solutions that could have occurred instead of having me incarcerated in a jail for 30 hours. This was crazy.
Well, Amy, let's just stop right there. Nice people like yourself always try at certain levels to meet the establishment halfway. But if the government, you know, wanted to make black people slaves again, we don't need to respond to them, "Hey, let's only make half of them slaves." This whole thing that they're engaged in is patently wrong. You were maliciously arrested. You were falsely imprisoned. You're not a felon engaging in vandalism. Chalking disappears when it rains or even has a light do. It is political speech. We live in a country now where they're locking people up who are protesting. They arrested people peacefully protesting at the DNC, and the Pentagon was over it and said protesting is low-level terrorism. And the Pentagon was going to the court saying keep them in jail. We're in a very dark period with the NDAA, the Patriot Act, the NSA spying on us without warrants. The system knows it's engaged in corruption. It's trying to extinct the First Amendment. And I was not aware until I saw just a few weeks ago, they're ticketing children that chalk in their own driveways. They're ticketing parents of children that chalk out in their commons areas. They're arresting mothers outside Houston whose children play at the end of a cul-de-sac on their bicycles and scooters. My children did that when we lived in Austin. They are arresting people who have children in the backyard now. They want to get everybody in jail. They're arresting mothers who take their seatbelt off 300 yards from home, stopping at the mailbox, the community mailbox. Now, that happened in Austin. They want to get you into the system. That's what the TSA is all about, is breaking your will, getting you used to people putting their hands on you, getting in your comfort zone. So I think you should sue them for false imprisonment. I think you should sue them for a civil rights violation. And I believe everyone nationwide should look at this and take it upon themselves to exercise their First Amendment in a new civil rights movement to chalk their political messages, whether it's 9/11's an inside job, or Google Building 7, or Start Page Building 7, or check out Infowars.com, or GMO kills, or whatever it is. That's why I did a program 5 or 6 times now, hanging up posters in legal, lawful areas, to show how they flip out when it's a political message, not a ad for your garage sale. We have to exercise this now or lose it. So I'm going to call for Free Speech Week, where everyone goes out and chalks the sidewalk, where everyone goes out and films police, where everyone goes out and films the TSA, which on their own website they say is legal and lawful, but they lie to individuals, including my reporters, and tell them it isn't. We have to let these servants know that they are our servants and we're not their slaves. Now, Amy, I'm ranting. You're the victim of this. Get to the point of her slapping the cuffs on you, what transpired there, and where we're going.
Well, so when she realized that I was not going to give her any of my personal information other than my name and that I live in town, she said, well, then I'm going to have to arrest you. She called her supervising officer over at some point. This is not a young officer. She was not a rookie or anything like that, and neither was her supervisor that showed up in an SUV behind her. And they proceeded to put handcuffs on me. I still had my backpack on. They couldn't get it off. He had to grip my wrist super tightly to make sure I wasn't going to flee. And they arrested me. And then
No. That's all part of the act. That's why they'll do $1.5 million investigations of Amish undercover showing them sell neighbors milk to show the jury, look, they're dirty. It was secret, even though they were riding up in their wagon and giving it to neighbors who were really feds who demanded to buy it. It's all part of the act. We're putting cuffs on you. You're bad. We're not the bad ones trampling on America and basic freedom. You're bad. It's all part of the show.
Yeah. And I was calm throughout this, throughout my entire visit to the jail. I was respectful to all the officers. They were saying horrible things to me, happy that I don't have children. Someone like me doesn't have children. They treat you like a criminal to begin with.
Oh, they'd love to take your kids, yeah.
Yeah. So,
now, the state's 7 times more likely than any other group to abuse children, so.
Absolutely. Yeah, so.
They're all suspect. They're all suspect, not you.
Yeah, I mean, I was totally innocent at that point, and I did reference that, I haven't done anything wrong. I don't understand why you're treating me like this.
They have to dehumanize you because of the crimes they're committing. Continue with what kind of things do they say to you?
Well, at that point, mainly they put the handcuffs on and I sat in the squad car, for a while, and I was crying at that point. That's the only time I really lost
my... Well, that gave them a lot of pleasure. That's what, yeah.
It was scary, being basically you're in a cage, and that's the worst thing I can possibly think of. I mean, we're in a cage in a lot of ways with all the laws that we have in this country.
I'll tell you what's worse, being people like them that sadistically get off on a woman crying and that power trip, that's far worse. At least you have a soul and a mind and an intellect. Imagine them so feeble that all they can feel is grief, and I've seen a lot of police that actually suck and feed off of it. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure you saw him beat that schizophrenic man to death as he begged for Papa, whose dad was a cop. See, it'll all come back on him. And they were actually engorging themselves, because it's in good light, feeding on the death. And the 15 minutes of torture death is like a demonic, vampiric feeding. I'm sorry, but go ahead.
Yeah, it's out of control. The police state is a big problem. And I am a very private person, but I am happy to draw attention to this issue.
Okay, we'll continue. So you cry, you get down there, they say you're a terrible person, basically. What else did they say there at the camp?
I had to ask them to put my seatbelt on as she swerved over on the other side of the street while she was driving back to, to downtown to the jail. They continued to want to ask me questions, and I said I'm not comfortable answering any of these, so I'm sure she charged it as best she could.
I mean, there's no more any Miranda. She was just building a false case against you because she wants to nail you and put you in jail for a year for chalk. She wants to hurt the person for speech. She wants to hurt you. Go ahead.
Yeah.
You're the enemy. They're militarized. You're a civilian. They're the occupying force. Continue.
Yeah, so when I got there, you know, they were shoving me against the wall, ripping earrings out of me, my ear. You know, I volunteered that I had a pocket knife. I let them know immediately. They got rid of it. I had been totally groped. I don't fly because I don't want to be touched and I don't want to be scanned. And so I got it anyways by Ms. Police Officer when I got there. And then they took them off and let me remove the rest of them, you know, my nose ring and other things that they didn't want to touch. So I don't see why they had to do that.
No, well, know. Listen, these are people that the raw act of dominating makes their ego feel big. But continue.
It seemed to be the case. So there was two officers at that point, and once Ms. Good Cop, you know, or Bad Cop left, the other guy saw, you know, I had some Ron Paul things on my backpack and said, I like Ron Paul, too. What do you like about him? And I you know, talked about a lot of civil liberties. And
that's probably for his intelligence file, but continue.
Fair enough. But, yeah, so at that point, I was hanging out in the booking area for a long time. They took fingerprints. They took handprints. They took sides of my hands, prints, photographs. And then they were trying to pressure me into taking a DNA cheek swab. And I finally refused on that and said,
well, that way they can frame you later, yeah.
Yes, exactly. So they threatened me on that and said, well, you're going to be charged with another crime if you don't give us the swab. And I said, show me with the law. And they said, well, it's been shown constitutional. And I said, well, that doesn't actually make it constitutional.
Actually, it hasn't. But listen, let's just expand on that. Threatening you with charging you with more trumped up fake charges. If you don't let them dominate you.
Yes. And so they also let me know that I said, well, you know, will I get my DNA back after all the charges are dropped? And he said, no, this goes into a database and it's irretrievable.
Yeah, just like when you were born, they took blood from you as a baby. And now if you ever go get a DNA treatment, the companies announce that your body has been patented and they charge you millions of dollars.
Yeah, so I mean, I know they have it anyways, but they were claiming that I wasn't going to be released until I gave one, and so he did pull up the code or whatever, you know, crazy thing that they're saying it's legal, and so I ended up giving him one later on, so I hung out there, got some tubes of peanut butter and white bread. No water was given to me except for the filthy bathroom that I could try and drink out of the sink, and then I was outfitted with state-issued underwear, socks, shirts, the whole deal, and taken up to an area where there was about 15 to 18, it fluctuated, other women in about three to a room, and they were actually very nice to me and trying to be helpful and give advice and kind of their experiences and things, you know, as I'm being taken up in the elevator, I'm letting other officers know I'm here for chalking a sidewalk, and you know, they all know what the big problem here also is that so many people along the way could have done something and said this is out of line, let's stop it right here and let her go, instead of holding me overnight. I mean, it was a very interesting experience. I guess that's one way to look at it, but it was completely unnecessary.
Well, they have to play along with themselves. Again, it's all about theater. The government's good, we're bad. When the government injects little kids with syphilis or HIV shots as they've been caught or with polio and kill little kids, that's loving science. But when you chalk, that's big and bad. When the military lets the troops use DU, that's a death sentence, that's reasonable. But when somebody goes to protest, they have to be arrested as a terrorist at the DNC. And so this is the new America we live in. You live in California where they give children abortions at age 10 without parental consent. They give little kids morning after pills. They give them inoculations without parental consent. So, I mean, you live in a very, very, very globalist-styled system that is really the model of the rest of the country. But specifically, different news articles in the local paper, in the Register, in Patch, you said that was a better article. I mean, what is the community's response since this happened a few days ago to the thought criminal? I mean, are some people saying perhaps you should get the death penalty now?
You know, I have definitely been reading all the comments. There's been a lot of them. It's been a hot topic. It's the number one article in Patch this month, which is a great website. The author that runs that website gave me a very fair interview, and I believe she's somewhat awake, a good person. Yeah, a lot of the comments have been in my favor. You definitely have a lot of the statists that think that they should run everyone else's lives and use the government to do that. And there have been a lot of people coming to my defense, and obviously this is so silly. I think most people realize this is so silly. People are bringing up the children using chalk, the stores that sell it as sidewalk chalk.
Listen, you know, here's the deal. Notice how we as normal people try to defend ourselves. This is flaming tyranny. This is North Korea. This is Nazi Germany. And look, I'm going out this week, and we're doing it, guys. We're going to hang more of those Obama posters, more of the Republican posters, mittens, and we're going to chalk Austin up one road and down the other. I'm going to South Congress. I'm going all over. We're going to do it, and I'm telling you, I think everybody should go out now and chalk YouTube Building 7 and Google Building 7 and throw an Infowars.com in there. And everybody should fight this. The fact that these tyrants think that they've enslaved us so much that they're now going to try to put you in jail for a year and $10,000 fine. And the fact that the cops would hype themselves up and go, yeah, you're a bad person. No, they're bad people. They are shameful, pathetic creatures. That city needs to be sued. They all need to be sued to teach them a lesson. These people are unbelievable.
I think it's been really helpful in waking up a lot of people that think, oh, it's fine if I just go along and mind my own business. You know, a lot of people are saying, oh, she should have just shown ID. That's not the point. I'm not going to show.
No, they were gonna get you then.
Yeah.
I mean, they were going to get you then.
People are surprised that is even the law. And so a lot of people, well, you should change the law then. Well, yes, absolutely we should.
But listen. Even the ACLU covered this 3 weeks ago. I mean, people can look this up. They got the Department of Defense was commanding the police to arrest peaceful protesters, and then the Department of Defense, not even supposed to operate domestically, the military, went to the judge and said, keep these protesters protesting as low-level terrorism. It actually said low-level terrorism. The military being involved is red flags. Now saying arrest protesters, look, it's darker than most people know. And the fact that all over the country, they're arresting people for lemonade stands. I've got stacks of articles I covered before we went to this interview where people with $5 bills are being arrested. People are being detained. People that use money that's 5 or 6 years old before it became colored, they're being arrested. And the cops are saying later, it doesn't matter, it's real. You should have new money. Because you've got all these people that think they get their power from the state. And they think that it's fun to send people to jail. It's like a video game for them. Well, I've been ranting here during this. Other points you'd like to make about where this is going? What do you think of my idea to have everyone go out and exercise their First Amendment?
I think you saying that is certainly fine. I have yet to talk to a lawyer or anybody. My arraignment is tomorrow. If you'd like to call the Napa Police Department, I would certainly encourage that. I think your idea is pretty awesome. But yeah, I mean, I wouldn't want this to happen to anybody else, but we can't be afraid to speak out.
Well, obviously, that's people's own decision to go out and exercise the First Amendment. But look at the chilling effect where we're now, oh my God, don't recommend you go out and put chalk on the street with a political message. They may get us. I would go in tomorrow to the arraignment and say, are you guys really, this is land of the free, home of the brave, where you say, oh, we have a law, and you want to charge me with a felony for this? I'm sorry, go ahead, I'm ranting.
Well, I am living in the state of complete regulation. You know, we have all the jobs are disappearing because there are way too many regulations here, and it's not a business-friendly place. And people are fleeing the state. 1 or 2% in the last, 4 years have left to go to other states. So California's got a lot of problems. We're completely bankrupt. And the people here really need to wake up as to why all this is happening. They think their answer is, well, government should be doing a better job. We should have more government, more taxes. And, there's just a lot of people that haven't really heard that there's another way to think about things as far as actually being free. Everybody wants to say, oh, we live in a free country. You better stop it, because I'm really sick of hearing that we live in a free country when things like this happen all over the place. And just because they haven't encountered somebody it's happened to personally, they don't believe it's happening. But it is. This is just, I'm able to stand up for things, and I'm not scared, but a lot of people don't try and exercise their freedoms, and so they don't realize that they don't have them.
Well, look, public commons were meant to have chalk put on them. People should check their local laws, obviously, but my thing is unconstitutional laws are meant to be broken. Again, I go back to the government saying blacks weren't human. I mean, what's next? I mean, are they going to tell us, you know, we can't go out and protest? Well, yeah, they already are. And I think people should call the police department and say, shame on you. You ought to be ashamed. Good thing you don't have children, you know, like you told that poor woman. You people ought to move to North Korea or Communist China or Russia, you know, back in the 1970s or something. The police chief is Rich Melton, a shameful person for supporting this. Your arraignment tomorrow. 707-257-9550. 707-257-9550. They'll probably call for my arrest for saying call them. You know, pretty soon our free speech will be completely illegal if we don't stand up against these people. Folks need to call the mayor and others because this is just incredibly shameful. This is happening in Napa Valley. But I'm going out and I'm chalking the sidewalk. I mean, wow, what an evil terrorist I am. And you know what? You're right. People should Google. People should YouTube Building 7. People should find out exactly what's going on. Look, I'll guarantee you they're not arresting little kids that are putting flowers out on their street. I mean, what do you say about this being your political message? You think you were targeted because of that?
Definitely. You know, no children have been arrested. A lot of commenters are saying that they want to organize to have a bunch of kids do it and see what would happen. I think it's pretty clear that it was because it was political. It's an inexpensive way to get your message out. I'm sorry. I was trying to be economical about things. I could stand there with a sign, which is actually still technically legal in this city. But, you know, a lot more people would see it if I put it in various places. So, I think it's really too bad. A lot of people don't like what I was writing, but there are a lot of people that don't like what I was writing that have come to my defense because they had no idea chalking is illegal. It's crazy.
Well, again, they could pass a law tomorrow saying we have to sacrifice our firstborn. Many governments have done that. We're going to say no to that. This is a government of, for, and by the people, built on free speech, built on liberty, built on unpopular speech being protected, Amy. And exactly. We've got to come to your aid because they will take all of our rights if we don't do this.
I agree.
Well, I've been doing a lot of the ranting here. Other points you'd like to add in closing?
I guess I would encourage people to go out and just be active in any small way that you can. You don't need a big group to go do things. I like to go and hold signs by myself. That's okay. If you have a bigger group, it can be more fun, but just do something. If everybody just does something and in small ways, it's all going to start making a big difference and educating the people around you. Live how you believe, you know? Stand up for what this country was founded on. It's founded on freedom and being respectful to each other. And it's really, really simple.
Well, I know this. Everywhere my reporters go and everywhere I go now, far worse than even the brainwashed police, and they're getting pretty darn bad, they've been federalized, globalized. All over, people come up and call the police in front of you and say you can't videotape on a street corner. And so And I see those messages in movies and TV, so there's all these do-gooders that have been told there's all these threats, and they're like, finally, an evil citizen doing something. I get to call the cops, and the cops come. And, I mean, it's really a scary nation. We've got to let all these ninnies and people know that it's still our country, and just because they want to live in an authoritarian nightmare does not mean that that's the case, but I mean, what a dark time that all over the country, mothers are arrested for their children and fathers are playing even in their yard now. I'm talking about 10, 11-year-old children. How incredible that government is so confident in their tyranny that they're inoculating children without parental consent. I mean, this is scary.
Things are totally out of control. And my big issue is really the wars. And so a lot of people are saying, you know, 9/11 is a tough issue for a lot of Americans. They just are totally not open to hearing anything. So I was trying to not be inflammatory, but invite people to really think about things and investigate for themselves, which is the only way to wake people up is they've got to decide to wake up. But, you know, if you put it to them, hey, 9/11 happened, regardless of what you think happened, We don't even have to argue about that. The fact is we've lost tons of civil liberties, and we're in multiple foreign wars spending all of our hard-earned treasure, making more enemies.
And well, look, they've had national polls where as much as 82% CNN, Time Magazine poll, they had another CNN, New York Times poll showing 82%, one was 83%. I've seen, Scripps Sour News Service, 36% say total inside job, 50-something percent say quasi-inside job. The government, when Anwar al-Awlaki was on number three most wanted list, he was secretly at the Pentagon, one of the top guys in al-Qaeda. They blew up Building 7. And the secret is Building 7. That's another good thing. The secret is Building 7. Google it. And we're going to go out, we're going to write all this all over the street, and nobody's going to stop us, and if they arrest us, we're going to sue them. I mean, the fact that these authoritarians think that they've dominated this country and can extinguish the fires of liberty, I got news for them. We're going to do what we want when it comes to free speech. And I individually am going to do this, and I think every week, it's First Amendment week, Free Speech week, but let's make starting tomorrow, running through next Wednesday, First Amendment week, and we'll do another one coming up. I've got a big plan for this around Thanksgiving. And let's have everybody go out and do it and then videotape it and then talk to people and put it on YouTube. And let's get, because this is how revolutions against tyranny start, velvet revolutions of ideas. Everywhere we need to say, government is the problem. That's a good one to write. Infowars.com, learn the truth. Tyrants have taken over. Google Building 7, YouTube Building 7. You give us some ideas, Amy. What are some other things? Because it's not just our ideas. Everyone should go out and write a simple slogan to get people thinking and communicating that doesn't just come from on high off the teleprompter national TV written by the globalist.
Definitely. Something else that I'm really passionate with, I went down to San Francisco for audit the Fed on Saturday. I think that's using their system, not that we necessarily want to do it that way, but it passed in the House. Ron Paul's bill to audit the Fed passed with like over 70% of the Congress. They're scared not to vote for it. It's a bipartisan bill. And
that's right.
Harry Reid won't put it to a vote. I love calling my senators and other senators and the Congress people. There's only 100 senators. Call them up one day. It took me an hour and a half. Let them know you want them to co-sponsor S-202, and that's something real. If they vote against it, we know that they're sellouts.
That's right, and just because they blocked it this time, 15 years ago, Ron Paul couldn't get one co-sponsor. Now it's passing the House. Zbigniew Brzezinski wrote in his book this year, and he said 3 years ago on C-SPAN at the CFR, the public's awake to the puppet masters now. We're looking past their puppets, and that's really scaring them that we're on the march, they're on the run. That's why they're, hey, baby, we're going to give you a felony charge for chalk. Well, you know what? We're going to strike back nationwide, and I want to tell people all over the world, to your authoritarian governments run by these bankers, this is a global government we're facing. You do it in your country, too. Let's stand up. If by chance you happen to see this in North Korea, I know only inner party members have internet there. You should resist what you're doing. You should speak out. And I'll probably be arrested for speaking bad about North Korea. Our government will probably get really mad about that. But I don't like North Korea, federal government. Just because it's your dream, just because you're murdering scum that run our country, doesn't mean you're going to get to have your North Korean hellhole. I'm sorry. I'm not sorry I'm angry. We need to get angry and get motivated and get out there. What are some of the other ideas? What do you think are good slogans to even put on a message board? Because God forbid we chalk it. Now that you're an evil thought criminal about to go to the Ministry of Love, that's so loving. What are some good slogan ideas that you like, that people should write on their palm? Or maybe they'll be arrested for that.
I like anything having to do with breaking the left-right paradigm. I think that's a good one because then it shows that these people running our country aren't actually running our country. It doesn't matter who gets in, whether it's Romney or Obama. It really doesn't matter. Nothing changes, and people need to start seeing that. We go from Bush to Obama, and you wouldn't even be able to tell the difference. We got to wake up these, Obama people that were against the wars, and that's a big reason why he was elected was because of the wars. And then he signs the Patriot Act and NDAA. He's assassinated American citizens, and nobody's talking about it.
Well said. Well, I tell you, you are certainly a bad person. I have never talked to such an evil, evil person here on my broadcast. I want to be honest about that. Amy Larson, are there any Facebooks, Twitters, websites where people can contact such a dangerous, desperate, wicked person that would take hours out of their time to go out and write messages? I mean, I know the police will be watching this later, taking notes for the prosecution. They're going to show you. They're going to show you, you scum American. So what do you want to say to them while they're watching right now, thinking of how they can put you in jail because they're such good guys?
I mean, no, I don't use the slave Facebook. I'm not going to pay for a cell phone for a company that will sell my information to the government and let them spy on me. So I don't participate in those things. I would encourage people to not participate in a lot of, in any small way that you can.
Even more evil. And then you went out under the sun outside and weren't watching your TV or drinking fluoride water or taking Prozac. Crime. And you drew on the sidewalk. But thank God the North Korean officers were there. Just aren't you glad they arrested you?
Not so much. I would like Officer Bond to have to listen to my story and hear about my experience, what it was like in jail.
You're not human. They love it. You're not human to them because they're not human anymore. So just look, you're not going to reach them. They love it. They don't want to sit and listen to you. Teach them with a lawsuit. Teach them about the First Amendment that our veterans supposedly fought for. Teach them if they don't like free speech, get the hell out of my country. You hear that? I want to tell them something. You don't like free speech, then get your butt out of my country, New World Order. It's that simple. Go ahead.
I agree. You know, this is completely un-American, and they should, you know, they swear an oath to uphold the Constitution. They're not doing it, and I don't know what to do with it. I don't really have the means to sue them. You know, I know I could sue a police officer personally. I would like to let them know, you know, I let them know that you can be sued personally, and they do want to talk about, you know, the sidewalk is, you know, it's public property. I have a job. I'm a taxpayer. I thought I had the right.
You don't have the right to ride on the sidewalk. What do you think this is, America? In fact, I want to talk to him again. Listen. I know you're all about your power trip. I know you're all about the fact they told you you're God and you got to keep us in line to protect things and you're paramilitary and we're civilians. You're civilians, too. You are part of a globalist occupation army. The bankers brag they've conquered America. If any of you police out there in Napa have any souls left, admit you're part of a sick cult. And go on strike until they drop the felony charges on this poor woman. I know what my final comments are here that I want you to talk about. What time is your burning at the stake tomorrow? What time will they have the tyrants in chief up there trying to throw you in jail?
It's set for 8:30. There are a bunch of cases at that time, so I'm not sure the precise time that they'll call my case up. It could be a few hours. If people want to show up to support me, that would be awesome. I do have email. I'm not sure if I should give that out on here or not. I don't know what you'd recommend if I would get a ton of feedback, but that's pretty much the best way to contact me.
Well, if people are in California, in that surrounding area, they should just be there and support you tomorrow. And they're going to try to give you immediately. A court-appointed attorney who will try to sell you down the river as fast as possible, most of them. But I personally, before anything happens, I would say, Your Honor, I would just like to speak for a moment on guilty, not guilty. And I'd say, obviously you know about throwing yourself on the mercy of the court. Just on the off chance that you're not a total tyrant, this is what I would say. You should throw this out right now. This law, this is a national issue now. It's going to get thrown out. There's going to be litigation. I was putting political speech with chalk on the sidewalk. And you need to throw this out right now for selective enforcement on its face. You know it's your job to look at the rights of the people, the law as well as the facts. Do the right thing, Your Honor. Regardless, it's wrong to try to charge me with a felony for something that's not vandalism.
Right.
And then so that's on record. That's what I would say. Most of these people have that job because they're involved in all sorts of, insider stuff, and they'll see you as a threat. And they'll, it won't matter. We'll get you a constitutional lawyer or whatever. But it's important to counterstrike. You don't get their attention until you're trying to take their bass boat in their house. You don't get their attention until a civil rights suit. See, it's funny when they're taking you to jail. It's funny until the shoe's on the other foot. So it's time to strike back.
Yeah, I mean, if anybody could help me, that would be great. You know, I'm new to this. I have no criminal record of any kind.
Why you're bad. They know that, and they hate you because of it.
Yeah, they want to.
You're the enemy.
Record.
They want to give you that because it's a new class system. They want to make you a slave because you have a record, so they're above you. See, that's why they tell you you're bad. It's about, you're bad, we're good. You know, we're the good government. You're the bad one. See, it's all this real sick gang psychology.
Yeah, and that's totally how they treated me as soon as I was brought in there, you know, just cracking jokes and laughing, and they're having a great time singing and doing their jobs and stuff, and this is really happening. I had no idea, you know, I've never been arrested before. I thought I was being arrested. I had no idea I was going to jail.
That's where you go when they arrest you.
Well, I was in the booking area for a very long time. There were several other, you know, older men, I assume were drinking publicly, is kind of what I gathered. And they left. So I don't understand why I was actually held. It was clear I wasn't violent. I wasn't resisting.
I know, but they had to go through the whole show. And sure, they can selectively enforce things. Look, if you'd have been John Corzine, lied to Congress, stole $1.6 billion, you'd have been worshipped. If you were an Army scientist giving pregnant wives of GIs pills to kill her and the child, you'd be a top general. If you were murdering and killing people for the government, you'd be God. You're an evil woman that stood up to the machine with free speech, and that's why you've got to be destroyed.
Yeah. Yeah, it's really crazy.
I just can't believe how sick you are.
Well, thank you.
Oh, man, this is unbelievable. Well, listen, I'm sorry, go ahead.
If this could happen to me, police could arrest anybody for anything they want to. And so I just want this to be a wake-up call to Americans that if you think you're okay and you're a law-abiding citizen, I guarantee you there's some obscure law that
written by the criminals
that you would is totally irrational and you would never even guess, and they don't even know all the laws. That's the big thing. You call down and you want to know about a specific law, they can't even answer it. So you could be next. Speak out now, or it'll happen to you eventually. Whether, you know, it's just going to progress and get worse and worse, and I want this to be a wake-up call that things are moving towards a police state very rapidly, and we've seen things change in the last few years even.
Well, Amy, let me say this in final closing here. Things are getting bad very, very quickly, and 3 months ago we got the Army manual, which they responded to and said, yeah, it's ours, that for 2 years they've been teaching how to arrest people for their political views and put us in re-education camps. And they use the term re-education camp with its full authoritarian gravitas because they're just owning it. The system is like, yeah, we're tyrants. We bought $1.6 billion bullets. We're setting up FEMA camps. Get ready. And they're hiring all these control freaks who they've done psychological profiles on who have low IQs. That's come out in court. They only hire cops now with very low IQs. And it's very frightening. And they're like, we put you in camp now. You goodbye. And they would love it. You have to understand, we're in great danger. And so God bless you for what you're doing. And we look forward to following your case of the thought criminal who dared chalk messages about the government blowing up a building on 9/11.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you blowing this story up nationally.
No. Are you kidding? We're all in this together. Thank you, Amy Larson. Folks, that's it for our little visit there with Amy Larson. And that's it for this edition of InfoWars Nightly News. We're going to get her back on the radio later in the week for another interview and to take phone calls of listeners. The radio show's noon to 3 p.m. Eastern. It's also on XM 166. But those of us that love liberty have to stand together against the bullies. We have a case of serious tyranny, the worst I've ever seen. We are in trouble. And cowering to the system encourages the wolves. You ever had an aggressive dog run up to you? If you run, it's going to bite you in the butt. You got to stand your ground. And government is going about roaring, seeing who they can devour. Somebody else does that too. And here they are. We're now facing this. And it's time to get these servants who've been taught their God back in line. This is happening nationwide, folks. They're trying to train the police to act like Soviet thugs. They've got the public acting like it as well. And it's time to exercise the First Amendment like never before or lose it. That's why, my friends, we've come out with a new issue of Infowars magazine. I'm not going to show it to you until tomorrow on the radio. But let me tell you, let me just show you a little something. Oh, it's wicked, okay? And that's why we're doing this. We've dominated the web. They're trying to shut that down. We're also now growing other tentacles, other Hydra heads to fight the enemy, where we're going physical now. We're launching planetinfowars.com, the social network for you to get organized and post your legal, lawful street art. We're doing it all, and we're standing. You know, there's Amy over there, still over there. I'm going to say bye to her at the end of the show. She's thanking me. No, thank you for spending hours to go around and put stuff up on the streets. This is the spirit that will save us, right here in this young woman. That is going to save us. That, right there, you are what is going to save us. You are the answer. You are the resistance. You are the solution. And you use the freedom or you lose it. It's like muscles. So thank you for all your support over the years, listeners. We couldn't have done this without you. You know, I try to build up good police so they do the right thing, but tyranny will come to your door in a uniform. And that's why I spank them when they do this. They took this woman to jail. They enjoyed the pain. They enjoyed the fear. I am ashamed for them. And that's why I'm hoping they'll grow. But I understand they've been selected because they're psychologically stunted. And that's a fact. No attack, it's just a fact. You know, there's a reason they hired you. You got an 85 IQ. You don't know what that means. You're so stupid. But you arrested someone in America for chalk. So again, stand with her, folks. Hang together or hang separate. It comes down to that. If you want to get the new magazine, we're going to email it out in a couple of days. Free to everybody. Sign up at Infowars.com/newsletter. Again, great job to the crew. We're doing something historical here. Great job to all the listeners and viewers. We couldn't do any of this without you. And we need those prayers as well. We need those prayers. Thank you for those prayers. We cherish those. Those are more important than anything. Now get out there and take on the New World Order like Amy has done. And together, we'll let these tyrants know this is our planet, not theirs. This is our country. These are our children. These are our streets. This is our nation. These are our ideas. And we will beat you like good people have beaten the tyrants over and over again throughout history. Take your destiny up in your hands now to resist the scum, to resist the globalists. Get the fire in your mind that Thomas Jefferson talked about. And go forth and spread that fire of liberty in the minds of other humans. We're together. We're brothers and sisters forever. This is something special we're part of. We're going to see hell on earth released. But it's only during that hell that our greatest angels will be revealed, that our greatest attributes will shine forth. I'll see you back tomorrow, Lord willing.